Well, hello, this is Mike from Music City, and welcome to my latest installment of what I call Great Forgotten Records. Today, we're going to look at one, gosh, it's I can't believe that this record came out 15 years ago, it's this century. We've been looking at a lot of stuff in the 70s, but the record that I'm going to talk about today is the record High Society by the Silver Seas. Now, very interesting that this record had previously come out under the band's former name of the Bees. And here's a copy I've got autographed by the band. So has that ever happened before where the same record has come out when a band changed its name from the Bees to the Silver Seas? Now, that's a question for you. You know, they went for the longest time. There was a band in England called the Bees, and they went by, as you can see here, Bees US and Bees UK. And finally, they decided to hell with that, and they moved up. I guess I was going to say you moved up one letter in the alphabet from B to C and said you're the Bees, you're the Seas, but it's really with an S, so whatever. But anyway, what a fantastic, fantastic record. And you know, they're a Nashville band, you know, I'm going to come right out and say it. The Silver Seas are one of my favorite, if not my favorite, bands. And I always joke and tell people that, you know, U2 or Coldplay could be playing at the arena. You can give me a front row ticket. If the Bees or the Silver Seas were playing down at the basement, I'd go see the Silver Seas. Okay, so that's that. I've probably seen them, at, I don't know, 20, 25 times, and they're just a fantastic band. And, you know, the thing about them is I really think that they're a band out of time. You know, this record came out in 2005. It was their second record. The first was this one called Starry-Gazy Pie, which came out, let's see, I should have looked that up, 2004, a year before, and also a fantastic record. And, you know, I just think, you know, they're a great pop rock band, you know, with great vocals, great lyrics, great musicianship. And, you know, had they come out, I think in either two different generations, they would have been a much bigger success than they were. If they were to come out back in, like, you know, you've heard of the Laurel Canyon sound, you know, when, you know, Jackson Browne and Linda Ronstadt, people like that, I think they could have fit in that category and been successful. Or I think they could have came out in the 70s, late 70s, early 80s under sort of the new wave, you know, sound of pop rock music. And I think they would have been much more successful. But, you know, they've had some limited success. You know, and we'll talk more into the High Society record a bit. But let's just talk about the band. And the band really, the lead member of the band is a fellow named Daniel Taschen. Daniel, you know, is the guitarist, singer, songwriter, frontman. You know, writes pretty much substantially all of the music. He's had some co-writes on the record, and you know, Daniel is just a great artist, and one of my favorites, and also someone I've got to know here in Nashville. And he's a great guy, and you know, he's had some tremendous success recently that you know, you may or may not know, and maybe you don't associate back with the Silver Seas, but he won the Grammy last year as the co-producer of the Album of the Year. He and a fellow named Ian Fitchuk co-produced the Kacey Musgraves' Golden Hour record, and fantastic. You know, Daniel got to be on national TV. It was pretty exciting. And you know, if you like the sound of that Golden Hour record, you know, you need to go listen to the Silver Seas. There's some similarities in their sound. I mean, I think Kacey picked up on the best of what you know, Daniel's sound is all about. So if you like that record, I think you'll really like the Silver Seas. And then most recently, the latest exciting project from Daniel Taschen to just come out is a record called Blue Umbrella, which is an EP, and the artists are Burt Bacharach and Daniel Taschen. Some songs they co-wrote together. Daniel sings and Burt plays. Burt's only 92 now. Wow. And it's a really, really fine record that you need to check out as well, too. Now, the rest of the band on keyboards and also the record's producer is a fellow named Jason Lenning, who has done a lot of other production work around Nashville. The drummer is a fellow named David Gerke, who's been you know, involved with a lot of music in town too. Also sings great background vocals. And the funny thing about the Silver Seas is that they've sort of had a revolving cast of bass players. On this record, it was a fellow named John Dedrick, who plays quite a bit around town as well too. Also, you know, from time to time, they had a friend of mine named James Haggerty played bass. Victor Krause, Allison's sister, an artist in his own right, played bass. And for a while, they had a fellow named Lex Price playing. So I think, you know, from time to time, they've even toured did a tour in New York City one time and in London one time and had picked up just a sort of a rent-for-hire bass player. So that job for the bass player, it's kind of like a drummer in Spinal Tap, you know, keeps on changing. At least these guys don't implode or whatever they did back in the Spinal Tap days. You know, I really went on that limb when I told you that the Silver Seas is my favorite band. Now, there's a couple people I share that with. I think I need to mention. There is a very famous British radio personality, a fellow named Danny Baker. And Daniel has gone on and been on Danny Baker's radio show in London. And Danny Baker flat out says that the Silver Seas are my favorite band. So something he and I share in common. I think, you know, here in Nashville, you may have heard of Grimey's Record Store. Well, Mike Grimes, he and I together, we're huge Silver Seas fans. And, you know, I've been to many other shows at the Basement, and Grimey's there doing the sound. And as a matter of fact, there's a song on this record that Grimey had played at his wedding called We'll Be Walking, that I'm going to let you taste a little bit. Just a fantastic, fantastic song. And then just kind of rounding out some, you know, tidbits about the Silver Seas to mention. When they were in, they did a tour in London where they opened up for Graham Parker and The Rumour, back when Graham Parker and The Rumour had reformed. And while they were over there, they did the Later with Jules Holland show. You can find those clips, I think, on YouTube. They're a little finicky about whether they let those clips through, but I think you can sneak and find them somewhere. But that was a pretty big move for the band. Again, High Society. Again, the second record, and here's the first song I'm going to play. You may have heard and you may have not recognized, but it's a song called Catch Your Own Train. And where might have you heard this song? It was on Breaking Bad. I believe it was season one. There was a scene where someone, I think, was driving down a highway or something where they play this. So we'll hear a little bit of Catch Your Own Train, and it starts off with some great harmonica by Daniel. I've got a funny video on YouTube, and plus I've got a lot of live Silver Seas videos that I shot on my Music City Mike channel, on this Music City Mike channel. And I was at a show one time, and I actually got the clip there where Daniel didn't have a harmonica with him. And as he started doing this song, somebody in the crowd played their harmonica right on key. Daniel caught it and called the guy up, and they did a reprise of the song with the fan from the crowd playing their harmonica. Pretty awesome. Now, you know, I mentioned, you know, pop rock, some great pop rock on here that I really love. Let me play a little bit of a song called Imaginary Girl, and check out this fine, fine piano work from Jason Lenning. Great song. And here's another one in great pop rock vein, Miss November. Mm-hmm. great stuff, great stuff. I want to try to get some more songs. Probably one of their better known songs. Here's one called The Country Life. It's actually the opening track on the record. This is great stuff. Let me get one more in. This is a song I alluded to earlier that's a favorite song of mine and Mike Grimes. It's probably in my top 10 of all time songs, and I really mean it. Beautiful love song called We'll Go Walkin'. Heard this a lot on WFUV in New York get played. They were very kind to the Silver Seas back in the time.
Let's take a stroll, just you and I.
Oh gosh, beautiful song.
Now as the twilight fills the sky, early evening in the rain, hand in hand and down the lane, we'll go walking.
Man, I just love that song. Now, here's the thing. Now, I mentioned, you know, we're talking about high society. And God, I was really shocked to see how hard it is to find. It's here on Spotify. I believe you can get it at iTunes. But if you're looking for a CD copy, pretty pricey. There's a few on eBay in the $20 range. There was a couple just on Amazon, maybe a little bit cheaper. It did not come out on vinyl. Now, the Silver Seas didn't call it quits after that. A couple of years later, 5 years later, in 2010, you had Chateau Revenge as the follow-up album. And here's something really cool. This is called the red version of the album. They also put out what they call the blue version. And this is something else I've never heard a band do. Put out two versions of the same album, rock-based album, acoustic-based album. Same songs, just different laid-back acoustic versions. Now, that is pretty cool. A couple of years later, 2013, they put out Alaska, which is another great record. You can find that on vinyl. And then the last record that they put out, and I don't see a year on this. I got this as one of these Amazon manufactured CDs because it came out for the longest time only on iTunes. It's called Moonlight Road. Again, a great record, but we're featuring today High Society is the best record, the one you need to get. Please go buy some Silver Seas stuff and enjoy it. Hopefully we'll be seeing Daniel and the boys play again here in Nashville post-pandemic. Hey, thanks for listening. I hope that I've turned you on to some records that you may have missed. If you like this video, please hit that like button. If you haven't done so already, please go down and hit that subscribe button so we can keep you up on the content, future content. And after all, final said and done, Merry Christmas. It's that time of year, and we'll be back at you real soon with some more video content. So just take care. Now, this is Mike from Music City.